Again, I'm using aphobic because that term best gets across the idea that I'm describing. Again, it literally doesn't mean the fear of asexuals or aromantics. I mean, does homophobic mean a fear of gay people? Sometimes when I want to feel righteous anger or just hate myself, I'll browse the Ace Discourse tag on Tumblr. It's less of a discussion of ace issues and more of a nest of high and low-key aphobia. Basically, much of it is that one family member who always states that they don't have a problem with the gays, but it's so unnatural and they feel sorry for the gays' parents. That type of thinking sounds at first like acceptance and progressive thinking, but it's still grasping onto harmful and simply wrong ways of viewing other people. PhilosophyTube did a wonderful video on this kind of low-key transphobia, and I highly recommend it. I'll have a link somewhere. The biggest topic I see floating in this tag is the question of the LGBT-ness of asexuals. I know I already showed that yes, we belong in the community, but I feel it needs to be directly addressed here, especially because many have reasoned that as long as they want to be with people of the same sex, then they're allowed in, because people can just decide if a person's sexuality is queer enough or not to be considered normal, apparently. The problem here is the same-sex relationship part. To those who post such logic, there are two kinds of aces, basically gay or bi aces, and those they not so lovingly call cishets, or cishet aces. Their claim is that because aces who are cisgendered and heteroromantic look basically straight from the outside and can benefit from straight privilege, they don't belong in the LGBT+, as they don't face the required amount of suffering in their minds. On the outside, I admit, this seems to make sense. But if you spend some brain power on it and aren't actively trying to keep uncommonly accepted sexualities out of your precious clique, you'll notice that there's some troubling issues here. For one, you've never had to suffer in order to be considered LGBT+. Historically, all the letters associated with the community have faced both systematic and societal oppression, but the thing that brought them together was the fact that they aren't considered normal, i.e. cisgendered and heterosexual. At one point, they were all considered others and sought solidarity with others considered freaks for something they never chose. It's also important to note that two of the most well-known and commonly accepted letters, B for bisexual and T for trans, had to fight to be included in the community which they would later give its namesake. They both suffered for what they were born as, and yet weren't allowed in simply based on that point. So now to say that this is a box on a fictional checklist to be included is completely made up and not rooted in history. Also, bi and trans folk weren't initially included even though they fall into the same gender attraction and marginalized orientations, gender identities, and intersex categories that some people in the Ace Discourse tag claims is the requirement to be part of the community and uses to exclude those cishets. Bigots exist everywhere, even in the LGBT+ community, then and now. The other part of the cishet distinction is that the term itself is simply false. Calling an ace person cishet asserts that they're non-distinct from a cisgendered straight person, which is definitionally false. They're still asexual. How can they be heterosexual and asexual at the same time? Well, okay, I hear some of you exclusionists say, then cishet ace means cis-heteromantic asexual then, and they still can't be LGBT+ because they're still basically straight. Still no. There's still an asterisk when you label a heteromantic asexual cishet because that still doesn't accurately describe them, and neither does straight still. It's the same asterisk by trying to call a bi person in a hetero relationship straight. Both are still distinct from being straight, as all of the assumptions that come with the term don't fit. I understand that some of this comes from simple misinformation. That's not a terrible thing. I'll admit, it took me some time to realize the problems with this line of thinking. But for some, it stems from a blatant disregard and unwillingness to look into a sexuality that they don't understand. This all seems like applying reason to the situation, but really, it's fueled by aphobia. The desire to keep out those they weren't taught were a part of the LGBT+. A want to keep their special club extra exclusive. I understand that the more normal a fringe community gets, the less important it feels, but wasn't that the point? Proof to those who think gayness is a choice and that non-cis people need fixing that we're not broken and can exist healthily in society? Not only are people like this inadvertently working to keep LGBT plus identities separate from the rest of the world, but it's preventing an entire sexuality from experiencing the community and the solidarity that they enjoy. Asexuals are not stealing away resources. We're not basically straights trying to invade a space for those considered not normal sexualities and gender identities. We fit like a glove. And this applies to aromantic people too. They face the same brand of exclusion that ace people do, especially because many aphobes consider us to be the same thing. Funny part is, this type of thinking isn't new. We've seen it with bi folk being called gay lights, or that they're only valid if they're in a same-sex relationship, and how some people will only accept a trans person if they pass. Hell, we've seen it in those groups of guys who say lesbians are hot, but gay dudes are just disgusting. Years ago, those ace exclusionists could have been spewing any of this logic. It just so happens that the community they're a part of looks down on it today, but hasn't come to a consensus yet on asexuals and aromantics. It's not just these specific forms of prejudice that need to be combated. It's the shape of thought itself, the tribalist mentality, the kind of mindset that others anyone not already accepted as part of the us. The eternal us versus them that is often displaying racist can also sneak up in progressive communities like the LGBT+. It should be troubling if your initial reaction to encountering a type of person you're not familiar with, like demisexuals, is to assume that they're just mindless trend followers or attempting to hijack something you think is special about you. If you start from rejection instead of curiosity when you know you don't understand it, that should be a massive red flag. It shows that you're allowing emotions from your lower brain to dictate your thoughts, and that you don't really believe in the core ideals of the LGBT community. You're just as bad as those cis straights who reject gay people because they think homosexuality is a choice. Just like them, you're making up excuses for decisions you made based on a rejection of newness when you claim cishet arrows and aces don't belong in your tribe. It's straight up aphobia. It's an excuse to dump on societal minorities while calling yourself progressive and supportive of those society calls trash for their sexual or gender identity. So YouTube sucks at making sure subscribers actually sees the content they want from the people they subscribe to. I mean, for starters, there's a subscription button and a bell to ring for notifications to make sure you actually see their content. So if you want to actually follow the things I make or want to talk to me about just about anything without having to use Twitter, you can find me on Discord now. You can use this invitation code to get access to my content stream or just talk to me in my Not a Vampire crypt. You can still find me on Twitter at NotVampire, but the best place to reach me right now is Discord. Thank you very much for consuming this video, and until next time.